So the Electoral Commission has released 10 billion shillings to political parties. Funding of political parties is provided for in the Political Parties and Organizations Act. Now the funds are given to parties depending on their numerical strength in Parliament. And as tradition is, some of those funds will surely end up here, Nasser Road.
As the political tempo rises across the country, so is the momentum of these printing machines at Nasser Road, Kampala's printing village. These men will be even busier in the coming days as election candidates begin to spend on stickers, posters, calendars, manifestos, billboards, and other articles.
Actually, the business is not that too low. The customers are average, you understand. There are those who come, actually, and there are those who are in. They bring the work, actually. The work they bring is not that of our machines, so we try to send them to the other printers. We don't send them out, but we give the jobs to our friends who we know that they are also printers with those machines.
The period from June will especially be a busy one for printers. Most political parties have set their primaries for June, and candidates for elective positions are expected to double those from the previous election. This exercise, according to printers, promises to be most profitable.
We are expecting campaigns by the end of this year. So the councillors, ministers, the also these big people, presidents, if you never know, because actually they don't do the work from here, because for us, the company is not that well known, you understand. So they actually go to other big companies. So if you can do it, you can also print for the president, staff, the MPs, that's it.
Nasser Road has for years played a part in the documentation and stationery arena. Nasser Road is the place for businesses and individuals to go for promotional and copy needs. And now politicians too are swarming the place to get their messages across. Ronald Kato, reporting for Urban Today.